Hi, this is Jordan from Ipso Creative, and in this video, we will be exploring the content editing experience in Umbraco 8. Now, every website is built differently, so some aspects of the editing experience may vary slightly. So the goal of this video is to give you a basic understanding of an Umbraco editing experience and examples of how it can be leveraged. We're going to take a look at the Umbraco grid editor, the built-in SEO fields, styling and formatting options, and how to manage page settings. Let's dive in. Taking a look at our content tree, we can tell the different content types apart by the icons that are used. Oftentimes, a blank page like this is used to represent a basic content page. So let's click into About Us to see what a typical editing experience is like in Umbraco. Once loaded, you'll see there are two title fields at the top. The first field is used to name the page within Umbraco. It is also used to define the URL. The second field is for the actual page title. This is used in search engine results and can also be used as the H1 heading title for your content page, depending on how your site is set up. The next section is the main content or main body section. This is what's called the grid editor. It's built using a varying combination of columns and rows. It is similar to other CMS block editors, such as the new WordPress editor called Gutenberg. However, there are several unique features to Umbraco's grid editor, so let's check it out. To add a new row of content, scroll down and click on the plus sign. Here you can see we have six different types of content rows we can add to our page. Umbraco is built using a 12-column grid system, so you can create all sorts of different combinations of columns per row to use in your grid editor. Once you've chosen your row, you can begin to add content within each column. Click Add Content and you'll see all the different types of content elements you can add to your page. The rich text editor is a common element used to add paragraph text, headings, and buttons. However, you can also add headings as their own element. Adding imagery is incredibly intuitive and efficient with Umbraco. It pulls up a side panel with your entire media library where you can browse your folders, create new ones, and upload new media by dragging and dropping or clicking to choose files from your computer. Another content element that is commonly used are macros. Macros are often created for reusable content elements that are used in multiple places throughout your site, such as a featured product display, a recent blog post listing, or a contact form. Macros make it easy for developers to create various kinds of customizable content elements. One of the other powerful features of Umbraco is the ability to add individual styles to grid rows and columns. Let's take a look at another website to see some examples of custom formatting settings. If you click on the content row, you'll see a gear icon display that opens up the row settings and styles. Developers can create different classes that can be added to your rows, such as hide on mobile, tablet, or desktop. You can set anchor ID for anchor links. You can make a row full width on a page. You can set padding to the top or bottom of the row individually. You can set a background video, image, color, change the text color for an entire row, define behavior for background images, and more. And what's great is you can apply most of those same settings to individual columns as well. The row and column settings are an excellent example of the flexible and easily customizable nature of Umbraco. If we scroll down to the bottom of the page, we'll see our SEO fields. We have a description for the meta description and our keywords field. And remember, our page title field is at the top. Once you are done editing your page, you have the option to preview your changes, save your changes as a draft without publishing them, or you can save and publish your changes. You can also schedule your page to be published at a set date and time, publish this page in all of its child pages, or unpublish this page. Clicking Actions in the top right-hand corner of the page displays a list of actions that can be taken. These actions are also displayed by right-clicking on a page in the content tree. You can create new items, such as the content page underneath of this one. You can delete, move, or copy this page. You can create a content template based off of the content and layout of the current page. And you can sort child pages that belong to this page and more. The Info tab provides variant information about the page. Here you find the URL, the audit history, and other identifying information. One very important feature found in the Info tab is the rollback setting. This feature allows you to revert your page to an earlier saved version, which is quite helpful when it comes to managing content on the web. And that is an overview of a content editing experience in Embraco 8. Hopefully it was helpful to see how the grid editor allows the user to intuitively build out dynamic content pages, easily manage SEO information, and navigate page settings. Check out the description for links to other helpful videos on Embraco, and thanks for watching.